chat, you need to download the, okay, the session will be recorded. So if any one of you don't want to be visible, just switch off the video. But anyway, this is only for others to record the session. So let's start. So you have to download the application from Google Play or Apple Store. It's called Calliope. I hope you did it, but if not, do it now, because the easier way to explain Calliope is by showing you Calliope. It's the faster and the easy way to understand what can be done with Calliope. Once you get in, you will be asked for a channel. The channel is KA demo. I will type it down here. No, yes. And once you are in, you will be asked for your nickname and your favorite color. Both things you can choose, I mean. It's just to show you. The demo that we will do today is something like a really generic demo. Why? Because Calliope, what we have seen with our projects with Calliope, can be used for plenty of different things. So I will try to don't get into your creativity. I will just show you in a generic way what Calliope can do, but for what, it really depends on you. So forget about the examples that I will do it. I mean, it's just to show you what can be done. But at the end, Calliope is an empty tool. It's a really nice tool, but an empty one. So it really works when the storytelling is nice, when the storytelling is well integrated into your performance or into your whatever. But remember, it's an empty tool, okay? So Calliope is based on, well, Calliope is a transmedia, a massive personalized communication tool. That it's not true per se. I mean, you cannot do massive personalized communication, but we do some tricks in order to more or less do it. Okay, so we applied Internet of Things technologies and concepts to create different, let's say, interest groups inside your audience. So you are able to create different groups of interest. So and send whatever media message. I mean, text, picture, video, colors, or whatever. I will show you now what can be done. And you can send it to everybody, send it to a specific group, or even a specific group inside a specific group. In this way, you can create different storytellings. There are a couple of interesting things in Calliope. The first one is that it's a really connecting tool with your audience. People still don't have firewalls with the smartphone, so they are used to receive information from their family, friends, or whatever. So all information you send by Calliope or by your smartphone is really contacting them. So for example, when we use it here in the Epica Foundation, we have a couple of actors telling you have to leave, and everybody knows that this is an actor, it's okay. But when you send them a message to their smartphone telling them they have to leave, they leave. Because it's something like really, really, really invasive. You are contacting them directly to their phone, so this is a bit tricky. So I think that in this kind of crazy and really bad days that we have, that we cannot really touch people, it's an easy, or at least an option, to try to balance this to not have this possibility to touch, to try to contact them in a different way. Calliope has been used as a second screen, I mean, for sending additional information, for whatever, as a second narrative, as a plenty of different things. For us, it's important that Calliope itself, it's something like a character in the performance. So it can be a funny character, it can be a bad one, it can be just a narrator, a neutral one, or whatever. But it's important to keep this relation with a new character that appears in your audience, that it's not anymore an actor, it's a smartphone. It works also nice. I recommend you to see a couple of events that we have done this year, La Maldición de la Corona, Bodas de Sangre, and La Tempestad, where we use it as a way to complement a live streaming. So you have the main, let's say, main event in your laptop, but you are using your smartphone for complementing all that's happening. It's also a nice way to gather feedback with them and all this stuff. So is everybody connected in a demo? Yeah, perfect. So then you can put your volume up. I will send you the first one. Now you have to have thanks for downloading me, or gracias por descargarme. Calliope is multi-language, so it works in as many languages as you want. Normally, the application check your iOS language, and if this language is available, you will get it in this language. If not, you will get the default one. That means that if you have your smartphone in Russian, you will get it in English. I hope our Danish friends now have it in English, but the rest should be in Spanish, correct? So I will show you first the very, very important thing, that Calliope is really fast. It's really fast. That's good and it's not good. I mean, you have to take it into account. Normally it's really fast and it works perfectly when you are in a live event. But when you are using this kind of live streaming, you have to take into account that the streaming has some delay. So you have to launch Calliope according to the live stream, not according to the real thing. Because if not, you will be so fast. I will show you. I will send a new message in 1, 2, 3. You got it, right? It's so fast. I mean, normally it's always under half a second. That's perfectly when you are there with your audience, so you can decide exactly at any moment when to send a message. But if you're doing live streaming, you have to consider the YouTube, let's say, delay. Okay, got it? So I will do the demo. So let's check if everybody is connected. And you can do fancy things like that. So here you see your lantern. I switch on your lantern, that's nice. I can switch it on or off. This is nice because this is something like people, you can decide when it will be bright, where it will sound, when it will not sound or whatever. So you can control it by any device. Okay, now we are all, let's go. My name is Calliope, cool. And I will show you what can be done with Calliope. This is, again, as many languages as possible. I send you now, if you show me, you will have all the same information, well, according to the language. But then, if we move here, this is, I have it red. You have yellow, red, it will depend on the color you choose. That's only to show you that we can do interest groups, I mean. That means that I can send a different message to women's, men's, women that like football, women that likes basketball, or men that doesn't like basketball. I mean, according to your profile, you are able to segmentate and create interest groups to create different things. Here it's nice because when we are doing here, for example, in Epica Foundation, when we had the chance to put people together, it will be nice because from at the very beginning, you can split people. And then even if you are there with your couple, you are suddenly separated. That this is crazy because it's something like once you are isolated, it's easier to be more, let's say, invasive, you know? You get strong or you feel stronger when you are with your couple or with your friends. But if we spread people, oof, it's a bit tricky. So here it's exactly the same. You can create different storytellings according to the things. How many questions? Okay. Questions, I will solve the questions at the end, but at the end you can do as many questions as you like. The problem is that normally people get frustrated, so we recommend you to do 4, 5, 6, but not more than 6, because if not, people is something like last for 10 minutes trying to do something like a survey. Then should be something fast enough to do it. And that's why, for example, you see the filters. Normally there are plenty different filters, but it should be, let's say, always a selection. So if you ask for the favorite color, don't put an empty text. So let them ask between red, yellow, green, or whatever, because there are too many green colors. I mean, it could be something like a dark green, or soft green or whatever. So this is a request. So let's go. Color sequences and sound. And also this is nice because I will ask you to unmute yourself and put your volume, I mean, just to create, because we are not too much, okay, 13 people. So it's just to create a bit of cacophony, but I can send you different groups. There are some of you with wolves, but not all of you, and other ones.
Oh my God.
And then we have 4 different groups of wolves. That's really nice. You can create really organic sounds because you are using your audience speakers, so that this is nice because they are located around the space or wherever. This is a bit tricky, and of course I can shut down always. I will show you later the even the control, because even we have you have a panic button, so if something gets wrong, so click the panic button and everything stops. That's always for safety, say two things. So this is, I really like these things. For those that are at home, I recommend you to switch off the lights just for a second, because this is a nice thing. Of course, our Puerto Rican, our people for Puerto Rico that are in the streets, so don't worry. So, but let's go. I will send you the perfect storm. That's nice. I like it. And also the good thing is that I am sending you different storms to each of you. That means that when you have a room, plenty of people, it's even more nice, because the storm is created organically. So let's create some natural ambience. It's more or less the same, but sending you different frogs. I have the blue one. And here I have another one. Yeah. So just to show you that you can send different videos. At the end, it's exactly the same. So, okay. Once we have the chance to have, this is something like half of the video. So if you are two there, you can put the video and create like a puzzle. Okay. Let's go. As you can see, there are plenty of different options. What I was trying to show you is that we can send text. We can send images, we can send videos, we can send colors, we can switch on and off the lantern. We can send sounds, default sounds for each message. We can send vibration for each message or not. And we can send whatever thing we want for the whole audience, for a group or even a specific group or even an individual. If I know your name or your nickname, I can send you a direct message to you, okay? So that's, you can say, okay, thank you, Alicia. So Alicia is there. I mean, Jan Elena was there. They are on the chat trying to send you all the information. So let me show you, this is not all. Well, you can use it for whatever thing you want. Okay, I will show you another thing. Let's go, we can send this kind of quiz that we said, that this is something like a, this is pure entertainment. I mean, this always has a correct or an incorrect answer. So in anything you click, you will get a contra answer. So this is for waiting or for getting entertainment. And then you can send as many different things as you want. But also we have this, but this is a survey. I mean, from this, we gather the feedback. And then after the show, you are able to know, or during the show, on the fly, you can know the results you got from your audience. That means that you know how much of you will donate your body to the science. And if this is 30%, 40%, 50%, and this is nice. Because in this way, you can create a bit more things and even gather feedback from the audience. Of course, you can ask them, did you like the show? Okay, this is okay. It's not the way to, I mean, the most interesting thing, but you can do it. And I think that more or less we have done it for plenty of different things. I mean, let's say, should I show some videos? For example, here in the creation, this was for an opera we did with La Fura. We used the devices. Let me shut down at least my one. This was used in the show. I mean, this circle was done with tablets. I mean, the chorus had a tablet where they were singing, and once they finished, they put it on some scenography, so we are able to create circular screens or whatever kind of screen, because we know where they were, and then we are able to draw whatever thing. We have done it for glitch. What's that glitch? It was something like this is a fancy thing, because this is people really, once you are interacting with them, you can tell them that you are controlling your data and all this stuff, and they believe this is, it's true. It's not, I mean, it's just, but it works in escape room. So And even we use for accessibility too. I mean, but it's okay. And for creating interactions or whatever. So let me go back to the start. Okay, see? Okay, Alicia was telling here that they will send you a link with the example we did in the last show in Mexico. That was really interesting because it was something like a new character in the performance. It was really nice because we were even able to interact on the fly with the people that were chatting. So it was nice because you can answer even questions from the chat, but directly to the smartphone, it's a bit tricky, it's nice. So I think that's all. Let me, important things here, just back. First one, Calliope is really fast. Okay, so depends on the show, you have to take into account. So again, if you're doing live streaming and Calliope, you have to consider the delay from live streaming. That means that if you are using YouTube, Twitch, Vimeo, or whatever, the actions from Calliope needs to fit in a temporal window of about 10 seconds. Why? Because normally the streaming, it depends really on your bandwidth connection in your device or whatever, and then the buffer time that you are using in your live video, it will really depends. That means, a stupid example, Romeo jump into the scenario, start talking and leave. If you send an information about Romeo, it's nice because, for example, I will receive it when Romeo is getting into the stage. Some of you will receive it when Romeo is in the stage, and some of you when he's finishing his speech. That's nice, but don't try to do a shot. I mean, because it will never fit directly. I mean, if you are putting a boom, it will never be on sync. It will be on sync with some of the devices, but not all of them. It works when you are on stage, because on stage you decide now it will bump, bam, and it bump, and the bump sounds now. Okay? Understood?
Sí.
Okay. And then the other thing is Calliope. You have to find the balance with Calliope. What's the balance? If Calliope don't say anything in 10 minutes, I will, unconsciously, I will put it on my pocket and then I'm out, okay? But Calliope cannot disturb all the time the performance. So you have to find this balance between knowing the audience that this is an interesting tool, not too intrusive, but not useless to put it on his or her pocket, okay? This is not easy to do it, but you have to find this kind of character. Because how Calliope works, you have two different messages that you are able to send. You have this kind of push message. Push message is traditionally this WhatsApp message. When you have your smartphone locked, you receive something like a bubble. Calliope is telling something, and then you open it and get into Calliope. You cannot send too much of them because if I'm not in the performance, it's really disturbing me. But this live message that I'm sending you is once you have your application open. That means here, if I switch on off the application, I will not receive anymore. Okay? So questions now? I think that we are 14, so if you can ask me directly, for me it's okay, but I will. How many questions? I think that it was, how do we upload our content to the backend? Cool. I will show you, let me check if I can. Compartir pantalla. Déjame compartir pantalla. Me dice compartir pantalla, okay. Let me share with you, this is the Calliope dashboard, okay. You see, when I click here, this is normally here you create the actions in different scenes. And here, this is the timeline. So normally I am here. If I press on the next one, you receive the next message. I mean, then normally you create the actions here and then you put in your timeline. These columns correspond to the, for example, here is the color. This is green, red, blue, yellow. if I put one message here, let me remove this one. If I put this one here, only reds will receive the message. And if I put it here, all of you will receive the message. Okay, it's so easy. I will show you how to create a new actions, only just to understand that this is not the problem. I mean, the problem, believe me, that the problem is in the creativity, in the content you put on there, but not on to create it. Let's say that the in a couple of hours you are able to control the application. But for example, this is a new test. New test, I create an action. Let me remove this because I cannot see the controls. Okay. I go here, I put the text in English. Hello, everybody. I put it in Spanish. Hola a todo el mundo. And that's it. If I connect again and I send it to you, you receive it. Hello, everybody. And that's all. Then you can, for example, here put if you want a default zone or not, you want to vibrate or whatever. Okay, so it's easy. For media, it's exactly the same. You upload a new media, then once you have it, if you put here that it's a type video, then you have the medias that you have uploaded to the system and you can choose whatever media you want. Then for example, here, let's say, I don't know which one, security, for example. This is a video, language default, also in Spanish. Security, and that's it. In accent to you, ¿lo tienes, Alicia? I'm sorry, I'm live, and then I send you the video. It's easy, I think. Okay, and then the panic button, that shut up everything. Okay, it's so easy. It's not a difficult one. I mean, let me hear. Okay. Hola fuerte. Cool up. It was like a cool up. What's a cool up? I don't know what's a cool up.
Es un programa como el Milumin o estos programas.
Sí, como Milumin. Más o menos, more or less. Yeah. For those that are used to any kind of video or lighting software or whatever, it's so easy. I mean, it's more or less. We try to put the attention on this kind of software in order to keep this coherency. Because, for example, we have another. Well, we also use now Calliope for controlling the screens around the stage. So from the same dashboard, we are able to even launch videos on the screen and launch information into the smartphone. So in a single control, the orchestra director, you are able to control the whole thing. We are working on new devices, but this is for next open call. For example, we have even this, you know, what's that? Power supply. This is controlled by Calliope. We have a Calliope board on top of that, so we are able to switch on and off whatever electric things we have on the stage. But we are still working on that. So I hope it will be available soon, but not yet. And well, this is Calliope. I think that as you have seen, it's a powerful tool, but an empty tool. So,
but, Fran.
Dime.
Tengo una pregunta y es que, o sea, para si uno quisiera tener como un espectáculo y trabajarlo desde Calliope, tendríamos que aplicar a la residencia o es algo que está accesible ya para cualquier artista que quiera comenzar a trabajar esto.
Buena pregunta. I will tell you completely the truth. We are developing the tool. And normally what we have seen now is that it's too expensive to sell it to a small projects. That's why we opened this open call, in order to be able to give you support for free for doing it in your project. Because now we have to set up all the cloud platform, all the technical requirements and all this stuff. And for small events, it's, for example, we use Calliope in the Telmex Telcel Foundation in Mexico, founded by Carlos Slim. And then what's no problem? I mean, but the problem is that for small things, it's so expensive. And then that's why we opened this open call, in order to be able to democratize the technology now. In the meantime, we are working on doing it more, let's say, more affordable for everybody.
Yo vi La Maldición de la Corona, pero no en directo. Vi la grabación, el video.
Entonces te perdiste Calliope.
¿Qué?
Entonces no viste Calliope.
Claro, entonces mi pregunta era, sí, yo sé que usaron Calliope, pero no sé, te quería preguntar eso, ¿cómo lo usaron?
Sí, en el vídeo que se han pasado aquí, que de hecho el vídeo que se ha puesto aquí Alicia, in this YouTube channel, we create something like this demo by adding into the screen Calliope. It's a recorded one, I mean, you will see in the YouTube the main video plus a smartphone on your left side with Calliope, in order to understand the concept, even if you were not there on live. ¿Sí? ¿Me he explicado?
No entendí.
Sí, te han puesto un link a YouTube donde hemos hecho el montaje del vídeo de La Maldición de la Corona, poniendo al lado un móvil en el que se ve la información que salía en Calliope, para que entiendas un poco
Perfecto, gracias.
La tempestad, para que veas el concepto, porque pasaba esto, los que lo ven on demand pierden Calliope.
Claro.
El problema del Calliope on demand es que está pensado para el directo. This is a COVID, a pre-COVID tool. That means that we were always thinking on live things. That means that if you watch it in different time frames, it's not easy to send you the information, because you are assuming that everybody will watch the video at the same time. ¿Sí? ¿Más preguntas? Va. More questions. Dale.
Mira, te tengo una pregunta, es como una pregunta compuesta, pero van con la misma. Sé que estabas hablando que querías añadir otros dispositivos. Me pregunto, por ejemplo, esta pregunta va dirigida a poder controlar, por ejemplo, luces, riego de luces y también controlar Calliope para la interacción con la audiencia. Te pregunto, en el dashboard, no sé si tú puedes enseñar eso. Yo sé que se envió un mensaje que nos iban a... Sí, de cogernos en la residencia nos enseñaba. Pero puedes diferenciar entre lo que es para el escenario y lo que es para Calliope, ¿verdad? En el dashboard. ¿No? ¿O está todo unido en el sistema?
No, mira, normalmente, how it works normally is that we create something like a filter I will show you. So here, one of these columns is for the devices on the screen. For example, we have a module for Raspberry Pi that we have spread it through the, and then here you have raspberries. You know, you can create different tags and then put it in different columns. Then here, when you click here, for example, I will show you. Here, for example, is the demo that I show you different messages according to the color. So you can send in the same message different topics to different interest groups. And one of these columns normally are the devices. Or different columns, because can be plenty of different devices, but this is the idea. ¿Sí?
Sí, ya, gracias.
Entonces, el único problema es que tenemos módulos para algunos hardwares. Si quieres un hardware específico de luces, hay que ver ese módulo cómo funciona. Por eso estamos trabajando en este. Un módulo para PC, para Raspberry y demás sí que están. Pero si es un hardware específico, hombre, es guay integrarlo, pero es más ad hoc. ¿Más preguntas?
Sí, tengo una pregunta. Ustedes cuando hicieron La Maldición de la Corona, algo muy interesante que trabajaban era que había alteración a la imagen que se estaba viendo. Le pregunto, ¿eso es una opción que tiene Calliope para manejarse en vivo? ¿O eso es algo que se hace en postproducción? ¿O es otro tipo de software que tienen aparte a Calliope, como decir Max o VS, etcétera?
No, es pospo. Al final es todo pospo. Los vídeos los mandamos...
Pospo.
Sí.
Okay.
La Maldición de la Corona, yo creo que lo interesante que hicimos, tanto La Maldición de la Corona como Bodas de Sangre y La Tempestad, que cada vez hemos ido aprendiendo cosas nuevas y probando cosas, ¿eh? Aquí en la Fundación nuestra misión es probar, con lo que siempre queremos jugar un poquito más allá, ¿no? Porque nos podemos permitir, entre comillas, el experimentar y ver qué pasa, ¿no? Pero la idea es que mantuvimos, yo creo, un buen equilibrio entre lo que era grabado, lo que era en directo y lo que era tal. Entonces la gente no sabía bien qué es. Yo creo que eso es lo importante, porque si te vas demasiado, if you go too much to the recorded content, then you are competing with Netflix, and then you are done, you know, then you have to mix these things. So you can put some pre-recorded content, but together with live things, and trying to combine. To do everything live, in my opinion, it's also not a good option, because then you lose a lot of power. But you have to combine these things, like in the theater, that you have post-produced content on your stage, but you're doing something live. I mean, this combination is nice, because if not, you are competing in a non-fair scenario with Netflix or Paramount, and then you are out.
Hey.
But this is my personal opinion. I mean, okay. You can do whatever you think.
I have the question.
Go.
Okay. I saw the show in São Paulo with the Calliope. Mm-hmm. I am not clear what is the limitation of interaction with the public.
With the public.
Yes.
The limitation of interaction now in one direction, it's nearly nothing. I mean, I can send you whatever kind of information I want. The limitation is more in getting back the information. Normally, the feedback that we support now is all this profiling and all this kind of information related to the user and these pools that I show you, that I can ask you something and I will gather the information back. But this is something like a pool. I mean, did you like it? Do you like chicken? You click yes or no, and then I know you like chicken, you know, but you cannot send, now I can, you can, you are not allowed to send me pictures or videos or whatever. I can do some tricks because I forgot to tell you something. We can even send websites. That means that you will see it integrated in Calliope. That means if you want to send a chat, you can put a web chat in Calliope and people will be able to chat there. But this is a bit tricky. Because any kind of, for example, in the last show, we sent a really nice website that people were able to draw things and colors or whatever. ¿Lo tienes, Alicia? In a couple of minutes, I will try to send it to you because it's nice. And it's a super simple thing. I mean, it's something that was on the website. So we put it inside Calliope and then you can draw colors and all this stuff. But this interaction, it's still a bit tricky.
Fran? A question. So can you export the data of the interactions that the users have with each kind of media that you are having? So if you are asking questions about X, Y, Z, and they answer Z, can you then export the data to analyze what happened with the flow, with the storytelling?
Correct. For example, now in the last thing, more commercial thing we did, it was for the Balmain Barcelona Bridal Fashion Week. It was for the catwalks from the fair here in Barcelona. And we were able to gather the feedback, direct feedback from the audience, if they like or not the dresses that they were watching on the catwalk. Mándamelo al chat, lo copio, es un link. Todo el mundo lo puede abrir donde quiera.
Tengo una pregunta. ¿Puedo generar como chats o canales de interacción entre usuarios de Calliope? Es decir, si me elijo a mí y a Luis y nos abro como un chat, un diálogo a través de Calliope, esas cosas estarían disponibles?
No, es lo que te digo. Esos chats son por salas y es una web. Gracias. Y no lo tenemos. Mira, os voy a mandar ahora lo que os decía. Ya, mira, y de paso ya os lo comparto y así veis cómo es. ¿Estáis en Calliope o ya os habéis ido? Bueno, los que estáis en Calliope todavía lo recibiréis. Voy a crear una nueva opción, que es esta que os decía que habíamos hecho. Acciones, test, web. Vamos aquí, que es esta web, que es URL, here, URL, esta es la URL, y ya está. Y os la tiro en directo, online, sí, Alicia online, y ve, ¿la tenéis? Did you have it?
Sí.
This is a website, I mean, it's a already generated website, no, there is no magic there. But as it is integrated in Calliope, it's nice for the people. When you are putting colors, just touch the screen and you will draw colors. It's a silly example, but because sometimes it's the easier way to proceed. So try to find or develop something in the website and put it there. So this is more or less. So the interaction in one way, it's nearly everything. The other way, it's for data analysis, data metrics, and gather feedback. According to them, in the next version that we will launch soon, it will be a bit more expanded, but still there are a lot of problems with or issues about security and privacy and all this stuff. So we are trying to avoid people to send too much information. I mean, pictures or whatever. It's not easy. I mean, we don't want to jump in this kind of data privacy. Now the nickname, it's not a personal thing. You can put a shit in the name and it works. I mean, you know. So once you jump into the, because this is thought for massive things, I mean, for massive audience, so we prefer to avoid personal data and all this stuff.
Una pregunta. Este, el touchscreen este, ¿no? El efecto este.
Esto es una web.
¿Se ve de alguna... ¿Es solo esto o esto se puede llevar a una proyección, por ejemplo? No.
Sí, se puede llevar donde quieras. Esto es una web que hace esto. Es una web que está pública, que no es, es un ejemplo de 3D rendering colors. O sea, es una web. Bien. Que lo que pasa es que como yo te la integro dentro de Calliope, claro. Crees que es Calliope, pero es una web. Lo que estoy haciendo es visualizando una web que existe, que está y que está disponible. Por eso decía que a veces es muy, es tan fácil como enviar una web. So if you have a website that do what you want to do, send it by Calliope, because the good thing is that you will not leave the application, so you will watch it on inside the tool, and then I can decide that now you will stop playing, you cannot play anymore, because I remove it from your Calliope. You know, this is the nice thing, so they cannot stay there for forever, because I decide what you are watching at any moment. And I can put it back if you want it. I mean, if you can want to keep playing. So, okay. Más preguntas. More questions. No? Dime, dime, habla. Sí, no pasa nada.
¿Pueden escribir si tienen alguna duda a info@epigraph.com?
Púntalo en el chat. So, any other doubts that you have, please send us an email. So we hope you apply to the open call. I think it's a nice open call. And we are trying, we will love to put it available for everybody, but we still cannot. So we do this kind of efforts and we will give you feedback and technical support for everything in order to try to democratize a bit. So it's nice to have a lot of people from outside, also from País Vasco, of course, come on. I think that the only one from here is from País Vasco, right? But that's nice. I mean, we like to have as many people as so. I don't know. ¿Algo más, Alicia, Elena? Let me show you Alicia and Elena that normally will be those that answer you the questions. So. Because but normally they don't want to be on live, you know, that's why I'm doing this, but just kidding.
Una pregunta.
Sí.
Respecto a los performers o, bueno, actores, cuando son ellos los que tienen, digamos, el móvil, ¿no? No solo...
¿Quién está tirando mensajes?
No sé.
Mira, Pedro, por favor. This is our CTO that is always playing, you know? Pero lo voy a llamar aquí en directo. Me voy a llamar para que veáis que es verdad. Yes. Pedro, ¿puedes usar otro canal que no sea el K Demo, por favor? Estamos haciendo un webinar.
Qué bueno. No, te preguntaba. Cuando los que usan la aplicación son los actores o los performers, sí. ¿Cómo ha sido la experiencia de estar teniendo encima un móvil, digo, ¿no? Para actuar y todo esto?
¿Cómo ha sido la experiencia? Pues ha sido buena. O sea, la cosa es que se tienen que acostumbrar. Depende de cómo lo uses. Nosotros, por ejemplo, cuando ha funcionado bien es cuando los usamos como si fuera gente del público que va con su móvil. Entonces reciben información que tú puedes filtrar, porque al final si yo filtro por nickname y le pongo un nickname que sea un nombre muy complejo, ¿no? Actor 5 Pedro /3, no hay nadie más en el público que se llame Actor 5 /3, tres, ¿no? Entonces, claro, él lo recibe y la gente le mira como, coño, ¿qué? ¿Por qué él, no? Entonces, hemos hecho sorteos en los que ha ganado... No somos ninguno de nosotros. Pues será Pep. O Nadal, pero bueno. By the way, la idea es esta. La gente... I will tell you the truth. When we had a lot of problems with the chorus in this video that I show you, because they were singers, you know, and they were not used to the technology. And then they block the tablet or they do whatever thing they want. But it was not a problem with the technology. It was a problem with the usability they use, because they get nervous, they were singing, and then after that, they put there the screen and say, I don't know, you know, this. But it works. The thing is that you have to try to find this balance between being too invasive and being dynamic enough, you know? ¿Sí? ¿Más o menos? ¿Te ha respondido, Silvia?
Sí, sí, perfecto, gracias, sí, sí, ya entendí.
Vale, pues, ¿alguna otra pregunta? No, no a la de una. Nothing else. So please submit your application. Come on, we are here to help you. I think it's a nice thing. I mean, it's nice. And I think that the only good thing that we will get from this really bad situation is that people is getting used to technology. So more and more they are able to accept this technology as a tool. So people start downloading applications and doing, so we see even in the news, in the TV, doing Skype calls, you know? So I hope we forget this year, but at least we have something that will stay. So thank you very much. And anything you need, please send us an email and we will be here for. Do you plan to apply or not? I mean, just to... So,
yes.
¿Sí? Pues venga, vamos, va. Gracias, chicos. Un saludo.
Gracias, Juan.
Okay,
ánimo.
Thanks.
Suerte. Chao, chao, bye.
Thanks for your help.
Gracias.
Hasta luego, guapa. Pórtate bien.
Besitos a Alicia.
Chao, gracias.
Chao, gracias.